try out this quarantine kind of vlogging, which I am probably not even thinking of doing. I just never thought it'd be that entertaining. I've already made my coffee, and now I'm gonna put some sugar in it. Make sure I don't spill sugar all over the fucking place. Put in my cup of coffee. Cover slightly. So quarantine lately hasn't been easy for me. Going a little stir crazy that they'll do anything. And I'm sure everyone else is like the same. But at least I have my coffee. I gotta do figure out something else on getting sugar out. Cause that was bad. Just now. Let me dig in there for sugar. I got some crustables to eat. I'm waiting for the thaw out. Found out about this app called Instacart, where you pay $100 for a whole year membership and they don't pay the $3 to $5 delivery fee. And the fact that I don't drive, it actually, let me make sure I don't put too much sugar. I'm gonna be able to lose half of this. And the fact that I don't drive, this is actually the long run I'm gonna save me a lot of money. Like, at least, so if I calculate, if I went twice a month, I'd ride there back and forth, that'd be like $24, $25 times 12 is $28. So in the long run, I'm saving a lot of money. Which is really nice. I wish I would have known about Instacart sooner. I am not in any means sponsored by Instacart. I'm just over here so you guys can our view-ish. But yeah. So try that out by getting some crustables. I think we'll do that for now on because with this pandemic going on, it's just a hell of a lot safer. Gives me another reason not to leave the house. And then I recently bought little cages for rats for me to put a rat in because I can't put them in the same cage otherwise they might fight, so I have to put them in two separate cages. And then I'm going to hope that that works so that way I'll be going out once a month. Just okay once a month to get my snake her food. So anyways, I was saying, at least by doing that, I'm only risking getting the virus once a month by going out. Which should be an improvement over going out a couple of times a month, because I was going out twice for food, at least, and then once for my snake's food. Twice for my snake's food. That's like four times a month going out. And with this whole pandemic, it's just a hell of a lot safer. But again, like, I wish I knew about the service sooner. I had no idea there was actually a food delivery service that wouldn't cost a ridiculous amount of money. And then, I recently ordered, as well as supposed to be a pet carrier for like a little dog. This is you over there. That's my some pebbles way over there by the door. And that's my Jada right here in front of you. It's here supposed to be here for like a small dog for like pebbles over there by the door, I was saying. But I figured I could put my snake in there, my Cleo, if you look at my channel. She's getting pretty big, but she could definitely fit like in a little pet carrier like that. And that way I could take her out more. People don't have to be so afraid of her, which was good. It's gonna be really nice. I'll probably bring her into stores. Maybe I'll just cover up the carrier so people don't know what's inside. And then she can get more fresh air, and I don't have to worry about her getting hurt in there, and it's all soft and padded, and there's netting on each side, so I've got plenty of air, and I can take her in the backyard and have to watch her and keep her out of trouble. She likes to get into a lot of trouble when I bring her outside. It's annoying because I would like for her to like just roam around the backyard like the dogs do, but unfortunately can't do that. But anyways, every morning since this whole quarantine thing, I've either been playing video games, live streaming, or not even bothering to put makeup on or anything, because like, what's the point when you're stuck at home? And then when I go shopping, the same thing, I don't even bother. Most of the time, I just put my hair up. And, I actually grew to miss makeup, which is weird for me because I don't usually miss wearing makeup at all. But I actually really grew to miss it. The bonus of living with your boyfriend is, when quarantine pandemic kind of thing happens, you're not alone. I know a lot of you guys don't have the, are fortunate to have your significant other with you during this whole pandemic, which is really unfortunate. I can't wait till this is over. Like, I wanted to go to so many concerts these years, and that didn't happen. I wanted to visit a friend up north. That, you know, didn't happen. We visited once and this thing hit. My relationship's definitely been put to the test with this whole, like, constantly having to be around each other and not be able to go anywhere or do anything. So thankfully it has work. So we do have a, you know, our own time alone, you know, but that still sucks because he works overnight, from like freaking sometimes 8:30 till 6, other times it's like 9 till 6 to 5 ish. It sucks because then you get a boyfriend that's tired like all the time when you especially want to spend time with him, and that makes it a harder relationship, and then finances and everything. But I'm trying to think some other things to talk about. I mean, I've seen I haven't vlogged since like 6 months ago. And almost like a vlog. It was more like the noise you're hearing now is pebbles itching. More like a photo slide / video clips. I actually really regret not vlogging more there, but I was so involved with spending time with my boyfriend, and that's where he's from, Pennsylvania, and that place was gorgeous. I really wish I would have pulled my camera out more. Most of the time, you know, I really didn't have access to the shower, and I was mostly focused on him, and that was a crazy, awesome adventure to have. And then we were hoping to find a place here in California, but that didn't happen. Jay, you're not being very entertaining, my viewers. But anyways, last couple months my mental health has been suffering greatly. Yeah, Wes, come over here and be cute. Yeah? And I've been struggling with that pretty hard, which sucks because I take like 50 milligrams of depression anxiety medication. And for that to not work enough to like help me out here, it's been hard. And then I've been kind of more so drinking, but still trying not to become dependent on drinking either. I'm hoping that me and my mom and my boyfriend are going to go up to Northern California to the spot that my dad used to surf all the time. I'll be able to vlog that at least. I've really been missing vlogging. uploaded videos, honestly. Just my anxiety and my depression, like, and right now I'm too anxious to even show my face right now because my hair's a mess. It's dirty. Otherwise, instead of you guys looking at my cute dogs, you really got me talking with my coffee in my hand. Maybe I like struggle to even like upload this at all, really. But yeah, like I said, during mornings are like this. I come out here, spend time with my dogs, drink some coffee, wait for my boyfriend to wake up. And, you know, he sleeps most of the day because, you know, all night shift. And then even on the weekends, you know, he has to stick to that schedule. And then I watch some YouTube videos. Yeah, not on YouTube, I'm on TikTok. If I'm not on TikTok or YouTube, I'm on Red Dead or GTA playing those games, or on HBO watching The Big Bang Theory. You guys ever had those kind of shows where, like, you've seen it a bunch of times, but with your anxiety and how your brain is, watching that kind of show just helps you zone out? Because your brain's not, like, having to focus on it, so it makes it more easier for you to like just zone out, you know. Let's see. So yeah, I've been doing that. That's been helping me out. I also, I'm not gonna disclose this on my main channel. I don't even know if I'm gonna disclose this ever on YouTube. I got into a kink it started out as a kink. Everybody does on that. Use it as a kink. A lot of people use it as a coping mechanism. I got into that last year, and that's been helping me a lot. It's just, ever since, like, I don't know, at some point during this quarantine thing, it's made it even harder for me to do that to help cope with my bullshit. Which just makes things even harder for me, because if I can't go to the thing that helps me cope, I mean, you know, what am I supposed to do? Last night I forced myself to go for a walk, because I figured, well, it's late at night, you know? I don't want to walk with my boyfriend, and figured, nobody's out, so it should be safer to go out with this whole pandemic going on. I plan on making a video where I'm gonna play a clip of this lady pulling a tall Karen, and then rant about it, because just briefly, because this is a vlog, not a rant video. It's really got me triggered with these people that feel like they're so entitled not to wear a mask. Virus real or not, you need to be wearing a mask. And you're not blaming on your breathing issue, especially when you're talking a mile a minute and you claim you have breathing issues. Anyways, I'm not trying to go into a rant about it, so I don't want my vlog to be about that. But the whole anti-maskers shit is really... Pebbles, can you not itch right now? Thank you. Is really upsetting. Jada. She's just looking there lifeless. And again, I apologize for not pointing the camera at me instead of my dog that's just laying there on the floor. But major anxiety, I hope you guys understand. I plan on taking a shower later. I'm gonna try to vlog, I don't know, bits and pieces of today till I go to bed, and maybe try. At least. I mean, this vlog's already going on 15 minutes, so. But yeah, I've been really happy since before my 22nd vlog, I was single. Last year in February is when I got a relationship with this wonderful man, and I've been so happy. Yeah, we have our rough patches. Yeah, all couples fight. But, like, we are such twin flames. Soulmates. He's been making me really happy. You know. I just can't wait till this whole quarantine thing is over. You know, I just cannot wait. I miss going to concerts. I'm a huge introvert, but, like, being stuck at home all the time sucks ass. Pebbles, let me try to show you some Pebbles, because she's more entertained than my old lady there. Hi, Pebbles. Hi, Pebbles. Hi, Pebbles. Hey, look. She's so cute. Jada. My Jada right there, she's 13 years old. She's an old lady. I feel so sad because I tried taking her up and down the block, you know, just for a simple walk, and she can't really even handle it anymore. The poor thing. You gotta treasure every moment you have with your dogs. You really do. But anyways, I'm gonna pause the vlog at this point, and because this has just been mostly just me rambling at this point. And then I'll show you what the rest of my day has been looking like since this whole quarantine thing started in March. Luckily, it happened after my birthday. But still. Usually I don't have two coffees, but decided I'm going to have another one. Take out this one. Throw it away. Yeah, I usually don't have two coffees just because of my eyesight. Having one coffee is sort of not a bad idea. I don't know, it just makes it worse. I cannot, but I love coffee. And it's really relaxing, it's nice to have, and that's what I do. I recently got this coffee maker so long ago. Maybe call this girl. We haven't copied her in since. It's gonna save me so much money because one box is like 22 cups. And that's like $12-$13. Which is around like the price you'd be spending ish, depending on the type of coffee you get from Starbucks. So that's gonna save me some money, do that. And then plus this coffee maker makes it so fast. This one's for the K-cups, the one the cup thing that I had to put in there. This one's for grounds. And then watch this baby, it's so fast. Oh, and also, if you got to this part of the vlog, thank you for watching my vlog for so long. I really appreciate it. I don't think most people like watching vlogs that are so long. I watch this guy on YouTube, he makes hour vlogs. And I watched them all the way through, but I know that most people like watching vlogs that long. But, this one's gonna be pretty long because I haven't vlogged in forever, so I got a lot to say, and a lot has happened since then. A couple months ago I dyed my hair red, and then I dyed my hair black, because the upkeep of the red hair was just, like, too much. Plus, I needed to give my hair a break, even though I loved the red hair so much. And then, soon after dyeing my hair black, I decided to shave the side of my head. Not the whole side of my head, but, like, where my ear is, up to where my ear is, and that's it. I'm thinking about, like, where the sideburns are. Maybe about letting hair grow down a little bit there. Have a little wisp of hair there. Try that side shave look. See how that goes. My hair is, the side of my head has not been this, like, I have not had this short of hair since I was a baby. Side of my head has never been, this isn't that short for that long. How pretty my hair hasn't been. If you told me I was younger that I was gonna do this at 26 years old, I would have thought you were absolutely insane. But watch this baby, it makes coffee so fast. I love it. Oh, I love it. And then, recently decided to, like, do small gauges. Another thing I never thought I would ever do. My boyfriend has reasonably small gauges, and he's very persuasive. And it's like a month of first trying to persuade me to do it. I'm gonna say to all my viewers now, I promise you, I will not go to quarter size gauges. At least I fucking hope so. But I do not go to that size. My boyfriend says it's addicting and you're gonna end up going bigger, but I really hope not. But like I said, I have like swirly gauges. Like the medical steel swirly gauges. So I'm gonna do little by little. I'm not gonna rush it by no means. Because pushing these babies through little by little isn't really bitch enough. See how fast I made my coffee? I didn't fill it up as much as I did before. I must have. I didn't spill any water, but this may or may not be a really bad idea. Hold on one more as I change the angle of my camera. Not sure where I left off. Like I said, this may or may not be a bad idea because recently I was drinking coffees, iced teas, and that resulted in a hell of a lot of sugar in my system, which then resulted in me having this weird situation with my heart for like 3 days. I'm trying to do this one-handed. This is not going out so well. This resulted in me having like this, I don't know, rush of blood? I feel like a rush of blood. And then I get heavy and dizzy for like a split second. And as soon as it came, it went. And yeah, that was a really bad experience. I ended up calling the doctor's office, asking for medical professional advice on what the fuck I should do. Because it happened for 3 days, and the third day was having more frequent and more often. And that was freaking me out. So they advised me to call 911 based off the symptoms I was telling them. Which is what I just told you guys. The 911 people came. My anxiety went into like super ultra drive. Heart race fast, everything. Which was like so bad. And they said my heart was fine. The guy had to make a remark that, you know, ambulances are for emergencies. And that's like, I told you. I called you because I was told to by a medical professional at the doctor's office based off the symptoms I told the lady. She told me to call 911. I was just following what she told me because she's supposed to know more than I. You know? So that happened, and so then that I called the doctor's office, told him what happened, and now I called earlier and how I needed to get in to see a doctor right away. I managed to get like an appointment like 5 hours later, which was just like just sucked ass because my boyfriend tried as hard as he could to keep me doing deep breathing to regulate my heart better. And that I just got irritated by that because I'm still working on not having a temper. But yeah. Hold on one moment as I put some sugar in my coffee. So after stressing out majorly over the news of being told I needed to call 911, having the paramedics show up, checking my heart to see it's fine. Of course, my heart wasn't doing what it had been doing the last 3 days. I mean, how dare I do what it's been doing the last 3 days when I'm being checked out? And then, like I was saying, like 5 hours later, I had got a management appointment at 4:30. Went in there. They hooked me up to these wires, and my heart continued not doing what it was doing the last 3 days. Which just makes me sound like a very dramatic white bitch. Or exaggerating, but it's not the case. It really fucking happened, and it really freaked me out. Of course, they asked me if I was on stimulants, but I just drink coffee. Maybe one coffee. Not maybe. I always have one coffee every day. I really rarely have two coffees a day. I really rarely have a coffee at night. So yeah. That happened. Say hi to my Jada. Say hi, Jada. So I'm gonna pause one moment. Hi, Babos. Hi, Babos. So yeah, that happened. And then, a more positive news. I've been cigarette-free since around this time last year. I quit cigarettes and I now vape. And of course you got the tobacco company pushing out there, like making it out much worse than it is actually is, because they're losing out money. So of course they're gonna do that. Not saying it's healthy, it's just, this is according to a heart doctor. It's 95, you know, percent, so it's like 5% healthier-ish around that. Not that I know I'm not a doctor, so I don't know, like, the technical statistics, but it's less than the two evils, it's just overall a lot better to be doing that versus cigarettes. And granted, my vape, I guess, was like around 60. The juices, on their hand, like if you get 100 ml, it's like $27, and 100 ml lasts me a month. And then I get 60 ml, this is my vape. Isn't it so pretty? I absolutely love the wolf on the back. It's actually, well, partly the reason why I bought it. Plus, this is the digital screen here. I love it. So, until I think of something else to talk about on my vlog, that's going to be totally long, I was going to do it then. But for now, I'm going to do what I do every morning, which is scroll through TikTok and YouTube. I had another cup of coffee that I'll probably regret. But back on the heart thing, my heart's been doing fine ever since. After the paramedics checked me out and I went to the doctor's, that's my heart's like, okay, you're good. I was thinking about it. It was just a lot of sugar in my system. Because the doctor asked me if I was on any kind of stimulants, like monster drinks or something. What happened was, coffee, I was thinking earlier, coffee, iced tea, and like, I think it's about 2-ish containers of edible cookie dough. So yeah, a lot of sugar. I think my body was just trying to process all that sugar out of my body. So yeah, and I also started drinking kale again, still trying to figure out how to make it not so disgusting. And also not have like tiny bits of the fruits and vegetables in it, so I could be less grossed out when I'm trying to drink it. But yeah, I'm trying every day to improve my health, especially make the best out of quarantine. Pebbles, come here, baby. Come here. And this little one, she helps out. Yeah, you help out Mama and not be so stressed out. Yeah, you do. You're adorable. But you chew. This poor thing. I have to get a cone for her because she chews living daylights out of her butt. Poor thing has fleas and we can't seem to get rid of them. No, we can't. We're trying, though. We're trying. And here's my Jane hog in the spotlight. But yeah. I'll continue this vlog when I think of something else to ramble about. I hope you guys enjoy the vlog. I really do. I really do miss uploading as a hobby for YouTube. This little one's gonna lay in my lap for a little bit. But yeah, I have to get her comb because I gotta stop her from chewing. I'm messing up her pretty fur. We actually shaved mid back down trying to help her with the fleas. Of course, her fur's grown back quite some, but yes, it has. But we're trying to do our best to get those fleas away. The thing is, they don't really bother my other dog. My dog is over there now, hiding at the table. But yeah, really hope you guys enjoy this vlog. Maybe I should make this into part one, part two, part three vlogs, so that way the vlogs aren't so long. But anyways. Thank you so much for subscribing, guys. I'm going to continue this vlog later. Or do you guys want to keep just looking at this adorable thing? This adorable, fluffy, fluffy, furry baby. She really wants my attention, so I'm going to give it to her. This is much later in the day. It's around 7 o'clock. This is part of my day during the week. I'm going to try for now on. Put on makeup and make some TikTok videos. I'm covering half my face because I've only done half of my makeup. But I figured I'd add this part in because it's pretty funny. But now my hair's all clean and nice. I'm still in my pajamas, but I'm getting ready to do some TikTok videos. Hopefully, I still can. If anything, I'll live on my Instagram or something. I don't know. So, quick recap, before I was putting my makeup on, like last clip you just saw, I said about my life, where I went to work, and then I went live on my 3 Instagram accounts, spoke to my viewers, and then I made some TikTok videos, went live on TikTok. I'm going to insert the TikTok videos I made today after this. Really screwed up on, ending my vlog. Inserting, like, more little things that happened, after I put on my makeup on. But that is why I'm doing this quick recap, because I am not a good vlogger. Anyways, subscribe and all that shit. Please do enjoy me on TikTok in videos.
I'm just tired of being scared all the time, not knowing why. Trying to change and not knowing how.
Why protect those fucking freaks? Why? Because those freaks fought for our godforsaken fucking country! They donate to fucking charity! They pour their heart and souls into what they fucking love! They go out of their way to make a complete stranger.
There's a special place in hell for me. It's called a throne.
I shouldn't answer this door, should I? Hello? But holy fucking shit! Hi! What are you-